Thank you. Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We offer this Mass today on the third Sunday of Advent, Gaudete Sunday. We celebrate our joy in Christ's redeeming work among us, realizing that He who is to come is indeed already with us, unknown to us. This Sunday gets its name from the first word of the entrance antiphon in Latin, rejoice. And so rejoice in the Lord always. Again I say rejoice. Indeed, the Lord is near. And so, brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who see how your people faithfully await the feast of the Lord's Nativity, enable us, we pray, to attain the joy of so great a salvation, and to celebrate them always with solemn worship and glad rejoicing. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
The reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the poor, to bind the hearts that are broken, to proclaim liberty to captives, freedom to those in prison, to proclaim the year of favour from the Lord. I exult for joy in the Lord, my soul rejoices in my God. For he has clothed me in the garments of salvation, he has wrapped me in the cloak of integrity, like a bridegroom wearing his wreath, like a bride adorned in her jewels. As the earth makes fresh things grow, as a garden makes seeds spring up, so will the Lord make both integrity and praise spring up in the sight of the nations. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the song, my soul rejoices in my God.
My soul rejoices in my God.
My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Saviour. He looks on his servant in their nothingness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed.
My soul rejoices in my God.
The Almighty works marvels for me, holy his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him.
My soul rejoices in my God.
He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy.
My soul rejoices in my God.
The reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Be happy at all times, pray constantly, and for all things give thanks to God. Because this is what God expects you to do in Christ Jesus. Never try to suppress the Spirit or treat the gifts of prophecy with contempt. Think before you do anything. Hold on to what is good and avoid every form of evil. May the God of peace make you perfect and holy. And may you all be kept safe and blameless, spirit, soul and body, for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. God has called you and he will not fail you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me. He has sent me to bring good news to the poor. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
A man came sent by God, his name was John. He came as a witness to speak for the light, so that everyone might believe through him. He was not the light, only a witness to speak for the light. This is how John appeared as a witness. When the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, "Who are you?" he not only declared, but he declared quite openly, "I am not the Christ." Well then, they asked, "Are you Elijah?" "I am not," he said. "Are you the prophet?" he answered, "No." So they said to him, "Who are you?" We must take back an answer to those who sent us. What have you to say about yourself? So John said, "I am as Isaiah prophesied, a voice that cries in the wilderness, make a straight way for the Lord." Now these men had been sent by the Pharisees, and they put this further question to him, "Why are you baptizing if you are not the Christ, and not Elijah, and not the prophet?" John replied, "I baptize with water, but there stands among you unknown to you, the one who is coming after me, and I am not fit to undo his sandal strap." This happened at Bethany on the far side of the Jordan, where John was baptized. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We have in today's Gospel an interesting interrogation. The priests and Levites came out from Jerusalem to find out who this John the Baptist was and whether he was the Messiah. And it is probably a quite accurate description of the events of that day. Because after all, St. John the Evangelist, the author of the Gospel today, was a close disciple of John the Baptist. Hence all the detail about the interrogation. A few verses further on, it is mentioned that our evangelist was there the following day when John the Baptist pointed out Jesus to him and his companion Andrew. If you read the text carefully, you will see that Jesus himself was surely present on the occasion referred to in today's Gospel. Why else would John the Baptist say, "There stands among you, unknown to you, the one who is coming after me"? Then, the very next day, John the Baptist quietly points out Jesus to John and his companion Andrew, and more or less directs them to follow Jesus. It is a small detail, but quite interesting. It makes the priests and Levites out to be a bit on the slow side. Then questioning John, asking if he was the Messiah, when the real Messiah was standing right next to them, who says there is no human in the Gospels. The priests and Levites ask John three questions. Are you the Christ? Are you Elijah? Are you the prophet? Then they ask the fourth, if you are not the Christ or Elijah or the prophet, then why are you baptizing? John answered the three questions quite honestly by saying no. First and last were really the same question, since the Christ and the prophet were words used interchangeably for the Messiah. But John the Baptist, if you think about it, wouldn't have been very far wrong if he had said he was Elijah. Elijah was supposed to return as an immediate precursor to the Messiah. And actually, in Matthew's Gospel, Jesus, after coming down from the Mount of the Transfiguration, refers to John the Baptist as Elijah. After seeing the vision of Moses and Elijah on either side of Jesus when he was transfigured, Peter and James and John asked, "We know that you are the Messiah, but how is it that Elijah did not come to announce your coming?" Jesus replied, clearly referring to John the Baptist, "Elijah has come already." The fourth question is also worth some reflection. Why then are you baptizing? John, of course, does not directly answer, but makes a declaration that the Messiah is already here and says with heavy irony, "He is standing among you." Those proud priests go away unsatisfied with hatred in their hearts, confirming their ignorance and determined that they will punish John for his impudence. We too face such questions. We too are asked who we are and what we are doing. Often our questioners are just as hard in their hearts as John's inquisitors, but hopefully just as often our interrogators ask their questions with a real desire to know the answers. Many times they're us with a yearning in their hearts. They deserve to know the answer, and it is our duty to guide them to the light of Jesus, to guide them in the right way. But no one will ask you anything like this unless they see you actually being a Christian. actually carrying out your Christian duties, actually standing out from the crowd for the sake of the gospel. It might be that you ask that they ask you, because you have been brave enough to wear a visible sign of your faith, or because you have helped someone in need when others went hurrying on by the other side. But how to deal with these questions? How to answer without making a fool of yourself? Can I suggest that first you answer the question for yourselves? If you know why you sit here Sunday by Sunday, then it won't be too difficult to answer the questions of other people. Take a little time out to make this sort of self-examination. It will repay you no end. Not only will it help you when others put you unexpectedly on the spot, but it will give you an inner confidence, and certainly which will make you feel better in yourself. The church has moved on and it now realises that such questioning is good. After all, it gives the Holy Spirit room to work. It leads to a deepening of faith and increased trust in the teachings of the church. But if the church has moved on, then perhaps we too need to move on and open our mouths and share our faith a little. Jesus stands among us, just as he stood and recognized among those priests and Levites. He stands among us as a hidden presence, not threatening, not judging, not spying on us or interfering, but just there, cool, calm, and patient, content to let things take their course. He is simply a presence standing there beside us. Be aware of his presence, and you will have no fear when you face questions. Just realizing that he is by your side in your family conversations will surely help you to share your faith with each other and help you to find a common meaning and purpose of life. Knowing he is close to us strengthens us in unity and bolsters our faith. It gives us the courage to be fearless, witnessing to his name. Don't forget who it really is that wants us to climb up, who it really is that wants us not to join vocally in prayer, who it is that wants us not to shout out, who wants you to feel awkward when it comes to the matters of religion, who wants you to hesitate and stumble in the face of questions. The evil one is quite happy to exploit your reluctance. He wants to strike you silent and fill your mind with confusion and make you shy and bashful about matters of faith. Rather take heart from the words of Paul and let it be our prayer for each other. May the God of peace make you perfect and holy, and may you all be kept safe from blame, spirit, soul, and body, for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. I believe in one God, in the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For as men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. John the Baptist came as a witness to speak for the light, a voice crying out in the wilderness. Could we prepare for the coming of that light? We ask the Father to hear our prayer. Each member of the church on earth may be watchful and ready for Christ's coming. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That the leaders of nations may grant liberty to people who are being unjustly imprisoned. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That the poor and downhearted may hear the good news and know the kindness of active Christians. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That we may hold on to what is good and avoid every form of evil. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We continue to pray for those in hospital and hospices, nursing and parents. Remembering those who have asked us to pray for them, Bill Bennett, Margaret Higginbottom, Madeline Billington, John Bally, Iris Pierce, Carol Raby, Rosemary Stapleton, Stephen Bickett, Farman Holtzman, David Hopkinson, Joyce Waller, John Mullins, Brian Keeman, Louisa Simpson, Angela Ellis and Kevin Mitchell. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That those who have died may rest in peace, especially praying for the repose of the souls of Maisie Buck, Robert Ernest Facer, and Dean Wagstaff, and giving thanks for those who see his mind as at this time, Gwendolyn Ivy Kay and Ryan Michael Black. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend ourselves and all God's faithful people to the intercession of the saints in heaven, but especially we ask the prayers of Mary, ever Virgin Mother of God. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. A few moments of silence, we offer to God our private petitions. Almighty Father, your mercy is from age to age. You fill the starving with good things. Thus encourage, we pray in confidence, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
To the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, we offer to you unceasingly to complete what was begun in sacred mystery and powerfully accomplish for us your saving work through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is to be right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as with our ten we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all of them created by to give you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them whole, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night of his betrayal, he himself, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. He said a blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognize it the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Joseph, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Jonathan, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord,
through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever.
Amen.
In the Saviour's commandment formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, gracious in our peace and our days. That by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, etc. Apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and gracious in God, and peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Love God.
You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Say to the faint of heart, be strong, do not fear. Behold, our God will come, and he will save us. Let us pray. We implore your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feasts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bow down for the blessing. May the almighty and merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son, and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's heart, and enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
As you run the race of his present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity.
Amen.
So that rejoicing now with devotion of the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Physically as well. There is going to be a 9 lessons in carol service next Sunday evening at 5 o'clock. At St. John's. This is going to be carried out under the COVID rules and regulations, which means there'll be no congregational seat. The choir will be singing the carols and I've got an idea of something to do with the regions. Hope it's not me, I'm going to do all now. Maybe much. But that is next Sunday at 5 o'clock. And Christmas Eve Mass here is at 7 p.m. Midnight Mass is at 11:30 at St. John's, and Mass is here on Christmas Day at 10 a.m. It's also at 10 a.m. At St. John's, because Mass is being offered here on Christmas Day at 10 a.m. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
The angel of the Lord brought tidings to Mary.
And she conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Let that to be according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And the Word was made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us
sinners now and at the hour of our death. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
We beseech thee, O Lord, for thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion, we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.